Today's topic, we're going to be talking about speaking with college coaches, reaching out to coaches, how to follow up with coaches, how to respond with coaches. What's the important information to get across? So, it seems like I may be frozen. Can y'all hear me? Am I frozen? Ooh, North Carolina, San Francisco. Awesome. I love it. I'm here in Denver, Colorado. Technically Inglewood, Colorado, but we like to call it suburbish, just south of Denver. All good. Okay, perfect. Well, thanks for the chat. Letting me know that we're sounding good. Baseball from the great state of Wisconsin. Right on. Glad to have you on. Cool. Well, hey, it's 2 minutes past, and I figure we got a lot to cover today, so I'm just going to go ahead and dive on in. I guess before we dive in, I should apologize. I am wearing a hat today. At least it's a Captain U hat. I think my, we all got that quarantine hair. Can't quite get a haircut, so had to rep Captain U and Stack Sports. So thanks for tuning in. We're going to go ahead and dive right on now. So today I am talking about speaking with college coaches. How do we start conversations? How do we continue conversations? Why is reaching out to coaches important? We're going to talk about all that type of stuff today. So if you have questions along the way, feel free to pop it into the chat. I'm going to do my best to get to those along the way. If I need to stay a little bit later at the end, I'll certainly be happy to stick around and ask some questions. And if you have further questions or you want to chat outside of this live session, you can reach out to me directly at Eric, E-R-I-C, at CaptainU.com. So with that, let's jump on in. And so first, what I want to speak about is what types of info should you include when you're reaching out to coaches? Whether you're sending a message through Captain U, which, certainly a very easy, efficient way to get a hold of college coaches, whether you're, reaching out in an email or you're going to have a phone conversation with a coach, there's a couple really important things that you want to get across. There's certain little tiny differences in the way that you are writing a message that will help you get a better response rate. To me, in my opinion, the hardest part of the recruiting process is getting your first response from a given coach. It can feel so frustrating. Hey, I have these handful of schools I'm really interested in. How do we get the ball rolling? So that's what we're going to touch on first. And then I do get a lot of questions from athletes. How should I respond to coaches and how do I follow up? So we'll go ahead and touch on those after we kind of spend the bulk of the time talking about outreach. What should you include if you are reaching out to a college coach? Oh, chat's going. How many coaches do you recommend we reach out to? Great question. I don't think that there is a perfect number. When it comes to building your college list, and this is something that maybe we do another whole live session about. I would love to talk about how to build a college list. But you want it to be broad enough that you have some room to work with, some room to narrow it down over time, some room to identify differences between schools, what feels like a good fit and what doesn't. But you don't want such a big list that it gets overwhelming. You don't want to stare at your list and go, oh my goodness, I don't know if I've spoken to any of these coaches. I don't remember when I spoke with them. So certainly depending on the amount of time and effort you have, that can vary. But I find for most athletes, 10 to 15 schools is a really good place to start. So great question. Thanks for that. So being proactive is the best way to control your exposure. You don't need to wait around for coaches to come knocking on your door. I think that's a very kind of old school view of recruiting. And while certainly you will get some organic exposure like that, we talked about that a little bit in last week's live session. There's just no better way to get your foot in the door than to knock on it yourself. And if you're not out there introducing yourself to coaches, you can pretty well bet that your competition is. So the mindset of, I want to be getting exposure for myself. I want to be creating exposure rather than waiting for it is what this is all about. And there's a few things to consider before you reach out to a coach. First and foremost, think about your audience. These are college coaches, right? What type of information is going to be most relevant to college coaches? How, you know, think about this when you're coming up with the content to put in your message, and also in the way that you write the message. You know, college coaches are busy people. They've got athletes reaching out to them all day, every day. You know, that's just a part of their job, is checking out messages coming in from athletes. And so every little thing you can do to make your message easier to read, easier to understand, and easier to respond to is going to help you get more responses. So we're going to keep that in mind as we talk about these things we want to include. And first, what you want to do is decide what you want to get across in your message before you start writing. And to me, there's really three things you want to get across in a typical introduction message. First and foremost, who are you and why should the coach be interested? You know, we talked about this a little bit last week. If you missed the stream, you can go back and watch it. It's still on there. But think first, what are your key skills? What are the 2, 3, 4 bullet point level things about you as a student athlete that coaches are going to be interested in? And tell the coach. You know, I think often athletes are either a little too shy, you know, they're afraid of bragging, or perhaps they think coaches already know who they are and, you know, that it's not necessary to tell coaches about yourself. But here's the thing. If you tell someone what to look for, they will always find it more easily. So right out of the gates in your message, tell the coach who you are and why they should be interested. Hi, my name's Eric. I'm a wrestler from Southern California. You know, I think I'd be a great fit for your team because, you know, I'm aggressive in neutral and I have a great cradle and I, you know, pin 30% of my opponents. You know, that was maybe an example of something I might have written when I was going through college recruiting. I was a wrestler. So be very specific here. You know, it's not I've been on my varsity team for a year. What are those specific skills? Tell them who you are and why they should be interested. The second point, why are you interested in their school? Personalize these messages. It's just so, so important. If the coach can't tell that you know who you're speaking with and that they're interested in you and that you are interested in their school in particular, they're just not going to take you as seriously. So take the extra minute or two to think about why you're interested in this school. All right, so we decided, what do you want to get across? Hey, who are you? Why should they be interested in you? Why are you interested in their school? And then we want to have a call to action. That's the third piece that you always want to include in these messages. What do you want from the coach? I personally find the easiest way to have a call to action is just to ask a question. It just makes a coach feel like they need to owe you, they need to respond to you, that they owe you a response. So what we've spoken about so far, you know, this might look, hey, my name's Eric. I'm really interested in learning more about your program. I think I'd be a good fit because of A, B, and C. I'm really interested in your school because of X, Y, and Z. Maybe there's a major I'm interested in. Maybe I have a friend or a family member or a coach that went there. And then the call to action. Hey, are you recruiting for my weight class? Are you recruiting for my position? Are you recruiting for my grad year? Do you have any camps coming up this summer? You know, that's a really great call to action. Hey, do you have time to set up a phone call in the next 2 weeks? That's a great call to action. Have something that you are asking of the coach. It's just going to inherently make it easier for them to respond, not having to just stare at your message and go, huh, that's nice. They sent me some information. Have a call to action. Now, another thing I want to speak about, I think I spoke about this briefly last week, but what you're shooting for in your messages is you want these to be concise but thorough. Now, what does that mean? Concise means using as few words as possible, right? Thorough, it's kind of the opposite in most cases. You know, you want to be include as much detail as possible. And so how I see that influencing writing your messages is you need to be concise in not including any extra information that doesn't get your point across, but be thorough in getting your point across. If you have details that demonstrate your strengths, you know, hey, why should the coach be interested in you? Well, you know, I'm a player who has a high IQ for the game and great ball control. Great. Do you have a video that demonstrates that? Do you have a stat maybe that demonstrates that? It's okay to be thorough on the important points, but you don't have to, you know, you don't have to be like skimp on your words overall. Be concise but thorough. Hopefully that makes sense. I'll continue moving on. So the next thing is, and I'm getting in at this point to just kind of a couple random messaging tips. I think we got across, hey, you got to be proactive. You got to think about what you're getting across. And if you can do that, your messaging is already going to be better than, you know, say 50% of athletes that are just kind of shooting from the hip, writing whatever comes to mind. But now I want to get into some really, really granular tips on tiny things that will help your response rate, that will help your messages. And I see there's some stuff, you know, questions and things coming up in the chat. Don't worry, I'll get to you. I just want to make sure to kind of touch on the main points that I had down for today. So yeah, little tips here. One, be confident. It's okay to be confident in what you are bringing to the table. You know, I find one of the biggest issues often athletes have is they don't want to seem like they're bragging. They don't want to come off as overconfident. But you're trying to convince coaches that they need you on their team. So it's okay to be proud of what you've accomplished, to be proud of yourself as a student athlete, and definitely feel free to include that information. Second, be personal. Be yourself. You know, try and be natural. I mentioned personalize your message to the school, but really don't be afraid to let your personality show through in your messages a little bit. You know, I find often athletes will ask me on calls, do you have a template of exactly what I should say in a message? And I really try and push back on that. Certainly I have examples of great messages, but I think if you are comfortable in the words that you're using, in speaking about yourself, if you let your personality shine through a little bit, it's gonna feel so much more personal to the coach. And at the end of the day, coaches are not recruiting a stat. They're not recruiting a video. They're not recruiting a message. They're recruiting people. And you want to build rapport with coaches through your conversations. That's what this is all about. And so don't be afraid to talk, you know, speak a little bit about personal things. Why is there something special about this school to you personally that makes you really interested? Is there something really personal that drives you to do a great job in your sport? Include that information, that personal stuff really, you know, that last kind of 20% really helps in your messages and it does come through. And then the last piece here is don't be afraid to follow up. You know, I've already mentioned that in my opinion, the hardest part of the recruiting process is getting your first response from a coach. And you know what? If you don't hear back from a coach, that doesn't always mean that they're not interested. You know, I hear a lot of athletes, well, I sent out a round of messages to my top 10 schools and I only heard back from two of them. So I guess the others just might not be interested. And, you know, hey, a lack of response does not equal a lack of interest. I see in the chat, you know, somebody said, oh, where did it go? Good luck, everyone. Be persistent, not pushy. Thank you, Stuart, for saying that. And by the way, congratulations to your son. 30 plus offers. That is incredible. Wow. I would love to speak with you. If you could shoot me a note, eric@captainu.com, I'd love to just get a little bit more info, if you don't mind sharing, because that's a wonderful story. But be persistent, not pushy. That's exactly what I'm getting at. You know, you don't want to be sending them coach messages twice a day saying, give me a scholarship. But if you are out there, you know, reaching out to coaches with genuine interest, being personal, and you don't hear back, it's okay to follow up. You know, some of these coaches are getting so many messages from athletes, especially, you know, if you're reaching out to a school that's super popular for one reason or another. You know, say you're a basketball student and you're reaching out to, you know, teams that are in the Sweet 16 the last year. Guess what? So are most of all the other athletes out there. And, you know, everybody wants to play for the top schools. Everyone wants to go to, you know, those popular schools. And so sometimes you just got to catch the coach at the right time. It's okay to follow up. You know, I know for me personally, when I was trying to get a hold of the coach at University of Oregon, where I ended up going, it was not my first communication. It was not my second communication. You know, I think it was probably the fourth or fifth time before I finally heard back. And so it's okay to be persistent as long as you are being respectful, as long as you are coming with a little bit of new information each time. That's totally okay. You know, I think this is the hardest part for a lot of folks is the follow-up. A couple tips on how to send a good, respectful follow-up. You know, first of all, make sure to include a little bit of new information each time. What's new with you? Have you been training? Have you been practicing for your SATs? Did you get a good, you know, report card, a good midterm grade? Let the coach know what's going on with you as a student athlete. Let them know what you're doing to move yourself forward in terms of being a student athlete and earning a spot on a college team. You know, a lot of times when I'm talking about that first message, I'm asking people to remove all the extra information that doesn't get your main points across. And part of the reason is because a concise message is going to get more responses. But part of the reason is because we want to have more fodder for our messages down the line. You know, hey, if I've put every single video I have and every single stat about me and every single, you know, important thing I've ever done in my first message, there's not a whole lot for me to follow up with. But, you know, if I have held a little bit back, then I could say, hey, coach, I just wanted to make sure you got my last message. I'm really, really interested in earning a spot on your team, and I would love to find out more about what the process is in terms of earning a spot on your team. You know, I wanted to include a skills video showing me practicing my footwork. I'd love it if you could watch it and give me some feedback. Do you have some exercises or drills you recommend I do? What a great follow-up. It's short, but it's thorough. It's demonstrating to the coach that I'm super motivated. I'm asking them, I want to earn a spot on your team. What should I be doing? What should I be working on? What info do you want from me? And it's including an extra update. It's hitting all those important pieces that we really want to see in a follow-up. I apologize, my screensaver just went on, and I'm trying to keep up on the chat and stuff. And Javier, I see that you've got a question as well. So I'm going to make sure to get to you in just a moment. Just want to get through this section. We've still got about almost 15 minutes left in the live session. So we will get to everyone. If you have questions, feel free to pop them in there. You know, another important thing on these follow-ups is also make sure to follow all the kind of previous tips from the last messages. You know, be concise but thorough. Be straightforward. Think about what you want to get across. You know, just because you're sending a follow-up doesn't mean you want to send a one-sentence message. Make sure it's you know, following those same guidelines. And another thing that you can try is try different calls to action. You know, if you just, in your first message, you said, hey, coach, are you recruiting for my position? And you didn't hear back. Maybe try something else. Hey, do you have time to set up a phone call? Or I'm putting together a highlight video. What types of clips do you like to see? You know, try switching it up a little bit and see what might be more engaging to that coach. You know, often I like to give my athletes ideas on what to write in their messages. And after a week or 2 weeks or a month of practicing, getting out there, having conversations, each person will find a format and wording and sort of a rhythm that works best for them. And so, you know, feel free to play around with it. Feel free to experiment. If you send one message that you're not happy with, that's not going to kill your chances of getting recruited. It's a learning process. And, you know, you're going to be having many, many messages with many coaches over the course of your recruiting. So just get out there and experiment a little bit. So that's following up. You know, I guess the other question I have that I hear on following up is how often should I follow up? You know, hey, it's, I probably would have a different answer for every different situation. So I don't want to give too many just general rules of thumb. But, you know, hey, if you're a senior and you're going to visit a campus in 1 week and you need to get a hold of the coach, you know, I might be following up after about 2 days, or I might be sending a message saying, hey, coach, I'm going to give you a call at 5 p.m. today. And then I might be picking up the phone as well. You can certainly supplement your messages with other forms of communication. But I would probably be following up in just a couple days. You know, if I'm a freshman and I don't hear back, you know, I might give it 2 weeks. I might give it a week and a half. I might give it a month, depending on, you know, what my goals are and how many other schools I'm reaching out to and all that. So, there's no perfect answer. If you need more guidance on that, if that stresses you out, hey, you can always schedule a call with me. New members are free to schedule a call with me. Our gold and platinum subscribers can schedule, 4 calls per month with me. That's my job here at Captain U, is just giving advice to athletes. So if you're somebody who feels like you need a little more, hand-holding through the process, that's certainly there for you. But I hope that all these tips are helpful to anybody watching, whether you're a Captain U member or not. So that's follow-ups. The last thing I want to touch on before we kind of open up for more questions and things like that is how to respond to coaches. I find often athletes get a message from a coach and they freeze. They go, oh my gosh, what should I do now? How should I respond? I need to have the perfect response. This is my chance. Overwhelmingly, you don't need to stress about your responses. If a coach is reaching out to you, this is a great sign. They're already, you're on their radar to some extent. They're reaching out to you. So the first thing, and this, I cannot stress how important this is, but read the message. Read it carefully. Read it thoroughly. If you have to, write a couple notes on what the key points in the message are, because sometimes coaches are asking you to do something. You know, just like you should have a call to action in your messages, coaches have calls to action in their messages most of the time. Maybe they're inviting you to a camp. Maybe they're asking you to fill out a recruiting questionnaire. Maybe they're asking to see a video. Read the message thoroughly, and whatever they are asking for, make sure to respond with that, or make sure to take the action, make sure to respond appropriately. The last thing you want to do is get excited and just respond and say, thanks coach, really excited, and not have taken, whatever action they're asking. Another very important concept is mirroring. Now, if you haven't heard about mirroring before, this is, and I am not a psychologist or, a human behavior person or anything like that. So this is, my understanding is pretty cursory. But as humans, we pay more attention to someone when they are mirroring our actions or our speech or our, the rhythm of our speech or things like that. You'll notice, when people are attracted to each other, if one person touches their hair, maybe the other person does the same thing. It's just like a baseline human thing. And the same thing, that same concept can help you get more responses when you're in conversations with coaches. If there's a coach that sends a super long, thorough message, and they're talking about, all this in-depth stuff, and they're telling you every little detail about their program, that coach probably likes details. So include as many as you can, or as many as seem appropriate in your response. Break my rule of being concise. If the coach is being thorough, overwhelmingly so, make sure to mirror that. If a coach is sending one-sentence messages, don't send a full paragraph back, or don't send a 5-page message back. That coach clearly likes to speak in smaller, bite-sized pieces. Mirroring is just so important. It goes a very long way. And at the end of the day, it shows the coach that you're paying attention, that you are taking cues from them as to how they like to run their recruiting, and you're learning from it. Even if the coach doesn't realize that consciously, it's a subconscious thing. It goes such a long way, and I really implore you to pay attention to the coach's formatting and try and mirror it. Hey, we got Scott and Alex Rayer on the line or in the chat. Glad to have you guys in here. Thanks for joining. And Alex, hey, if your TikToks are showing coaches your footwork, you know, hey, that's maybe a little bit of a cutting edge recruiting right there, but it's not the worst idea I've heard. All right, let's continue on. The importance of mirroring, we touched on that. This is an important one. It's better to respond quickly than to respond perfectly. You know, again, I often find sometimes athletes get paralyzed with this feeling like they have to have the perfect message. And so they spend 2 weeks writing it. And then they send the response and the coach has already moved on mentally. And maybe they're talking and speaking with other athletes. It is better to get a message, read it, pay attention to it, figure out how you want to respond and get to that as quickly as possible than it is to sit around sitting on a message. You know, even if you just thank the coach, let's say a coach wants to see a highlight video. They said, hey, I saw you play at a tournament. I'm really interested in, you know, speaking with you about recruiting. Can you send me a highlight video? Let's say you don't have one. You know, that's going to take, let's say, at least a week to pull together. Still respond. Hey, coach, thanks so much for your message. It was great to connect with you at the tournament. I'm definitely interested in learning more about your program. I'm going to go ahead and send you my video once I have it together. I'm going to work on putting it together over the next week. Is there anything specific you'd like me to include? You know, that's such a good response. It's showing the coach that you're on top of it, that you're motivated, and you can kind of customize your video specifically for this audience. So that's all pluses in my opinion. And then lastly, again, end with a question. If the coach is asking you a question or they're asking you to do something, you don't want the conversation to die with you. All right, I responded to the coach. I filled out the questionnaire. Done. Now I'm going to wait around. That's not what you want to do. You know, hey, coach, thanks so much for your message. I filled out your recruiting questionnaire. Thanks for sending it over. I'd love to find out more about what, you know, it takes to earn a spot on your team. Do you have a chance to set up a call in the next week? Throw it back, you know, send another question back to him, or, you know, her, or, you know, we've got all sorts of coaches, you know, ask them a question back. Just keep that conversation going. That's the best thing you can do to continue building rapport with the coach. I think I mostly covered all the topics today. I think that was a little maybe more haphazard than normal, but certainly more in-depth than last week's. So I just want to retouch on a couple of the really key, super important points. And then we've got just a couple minutes left. So for any folks that have questions, Javier, I do have your and Gerard, I've got your questions. I'm going to get to them in a second, juggling a couple different screens here, so I apologize. When it comes to reaching out to coaches, who are you? Why should they be interested? Why are you interested in their school? And have a call to action. Be concise but thorough. Make your message easy to read, understand, and respond to, and be personal. When it comes to following up with coaches, don't be afraid to follow up. First off, it's okay to do. Make sure to include new information. It's okay to be persistent, but you don't want to be overly aggressive. And keep in mind all the normal tips from sending messages. And in responding to coaches, keep mirroring in mind. Make sure to read and always, again, end with a question. So those are the main topics I wanted to talk about today. I would be remiss if I didn't mention that, you know, hey, of course, I am with Captain U for college recruiting. If you have questions, if you want to learn about the Captain U tools, you can always reach me directly at Eric, E-R-I-C, at CaptainU.com. I would love to connect with any of you interested in learning more. And now with that, let's go ahead and get to some of the questions. So from Gerard, how soon should my child start reaching out to coaches? You know, anytime folks ask me, when's the best time to start sending messages? My answer is right now. Because everybody starts recruiting at a different time. I have athletes as young as 13 that I work with, and I have athletes that are in their senior year that I work with. And there are so many college programs out there. There are so many different ways to ultimately make a college team. But at the end of the day, it's sustained, consistent communication that gets you recruited. So if you're a freshman, if you're a eighth grader, certainly your messages are going to be different than a senior's. But I personally find it's important to put yourself on those coaches' radars, even if it's early, just for the sake of maybe finding out about camps or events or trying to connect with a coach at a tournament or wanting to go visit a campus unofficially. No, it's great to start speaking early, as early as you can. Now, from Javier, how does this work when your child is a sophomore? Some schools she wants to aren't supposed to contact younger students yet. That's a great question. And there is a lot of, I think, nuance to the recruiting rules and a lot of maybe misunderstanding out there. But the bottom line is, these rules are in place to protect your student athlete. They're there to protect the athletes. And so, while certainly when and how coaches are able to reach out to athletes has regulations, you as an athlete are pretty much free to reach out to coaches. You can check out the complete rules on the NCAA's website. They've got lots of great resources. But in general, you are free to reach out to coaches. You can ask questions. Hey, do you have any camps coming up? Are you coming to a tournament? And coaches can respond with some general information. They can invite you to a camp. And there are certainly other kind of avenues of communication. I would be more than happy to kind of chat with you about your specific situation because every athlete's recruiting is different. So if you want to go kind of further in depth, if you have questions, especially maybe after you review the NCAA stuff, feel free to again reach out to me at Eric, ERIC, at CaptainU.com. But overwhelmingly, I think the kind of rule of thumb that you'll hear going around that I hear a lot of folks is, hey, I know it's like fall of junior year when coaches can really start recruiting athletes, so I don't need to worry about recruiting about then. But guess what? That's when everyone is trying to work on recruiting. That's when everybody dives in. And you always want to think about what's the crowd going to do and how can I get ahead of that? So for the athletes that I am fortunate enough to work with before their junior year, I always tell them my main goal is for us to make sure the coaches at the schools you are interested in know who you are before fall of your senior year. Because that is going to make sure that you have a head start. That's going to make sure that you're not scrambling to get your information together. You're not scrambling to start conversations. You are in conversations by then. And then the coaches are paying attention to your season, to your stats, to your progress, the stuff that really, really matters at the end of the day. So yeah, sophomore, freshman, even younger, it's a great time to get started. Anytime you get I like to tell athletes anything you can do before about midway through your sophomore year is getting you ahead of the curve. So great question. Thanks for asking it. Through using Captain U, can you reach out to any college coach? Yeah, pretty much. There are certainly some requirements on, we don't have every club program in the country. If a school doesn't do, proper recruiting, if they're not like a NCAA or NAIA or otherwise kind of nationally sanctioned program, there are some exceptions. But in general, as kind of a rule of thumb, we've pretty much got every program in the country on the tool. If there's a specific school that you're curious about, we can always check on that for you. And again, you can reach me directly at Eric, ERIC, at CaptainU.com. Awesome. So we're just about 5 minutes past what I was originally going to do, and it looks like I need to plug my computer in. I'm about to die. But I want to thank everybody for joining me. This is obviously super casual, sitting in my living room. But I've really enjoyed just kind of getting some questions, and I hope that it's been helpful for any of you listening. Again, feel free to reach out to me, Eric, ERIC at CaptainU.com. My job here at Captain U is just making sure that our athletes and parents are happy, that they are getting the exposure they're looking for, and that they have the tools they need to be able to connect with college coaches. So I would love nothing more than to connect with some of you individually. If you have questions about Captain U, if you have questions about recruiting, I'm just here to be a resource. And so stay safe, stay healthy, stay inside as best you can. Don't let being cooped up keep you from making recruiting progress. How long has Captain U been around? That's a great question. I want to say it's like 13, 14 years, but I could be off by a little bit. We were started by a former college coach, Avi Stopper. We have very humble beginnings. We were very, very small for a long time. I've been with Captain U for 7 years. So great question. And again, thanks to everybody for joining. We're going to do this every week. So if you have things you want to hear about, make sure to leave it in the comments of the video. I'm going to go back and check and use that as inspiration for future live sessions. So thanks so much, everyone, for joining, and we'll catch you next week.